Okay guys, just pick this up for free. Gave it a little test and she does fire up. It's really, really rough looking, as you can see, like all of the, yeah, that's looking pretty shit. Really dirty and dusty, but I'll be back in a second just to show you guys something. Yeah, so here we go. Just take a second or so for the, yeah, and of course that flickering is not actually showing on the screen like that. That's just because of the frame rate or the CRT stuff, but as you can see, it does work. Volume works. Yeah, National Quintrix, just like the one we had when we were kids. Yeah, so yeah, as you can see, all along there, and I also noticed once I cleaned it up, there's a little bit there. Little first pass over. Still got a lot more sanding to go and some filling, but she's starting to look a little bit nicer. A bit further along, guys, we're like up. Gone through this morning and sanded back those scratches that we had earlier back to the bare plastic, and then just using an acrylic polished it all up. So I took the front off the top here, all the way along the sides and all the way along here, and then just with gradually finer and finer wet and dry sandpaper, got it back to as smooth as I could, and then applied some acrylic polish. That of course has lifted a little bit of the thing, so I'll just give it another day to dry, and then I'll do some fine tuning. I'll tape this up and put some wood glue down, and then give it its final sand back before I recover it. I'm getting close. Yeah, also, did quite a bit of adhesive removal today as well, so it's quite a bit smoother. Yeah, so we're slowly getting there. Yeah, so, okay, I've done it's dried overnight, and then I've, this morning, got up, have whacked on a coat of PVA, and then sanded that back. So you can see now we've got these frayed edges are looking way better, and I'm going to give it one more coat, but you can see like just how much smoother it is. yeah, I still need to give it another go over, but at least it's not going to pull up when I apply the new vinyl cover, and it's certainly starting to look a whole lot flusher than when I started. Okay, back soon.
Yeah, so it's the
second coat after a bit more of a sandback. It's the second coat of the wood glue. Yeah, I'll let that cure overnight. I'll give it a super fine, like, been doing it with 240 grit sandpaper. I'll knock that down to like 400 grit to do its final smooth down, and that'll be it. I'll try really hard not to sand through any of the glue, just to, you know, smooth off any of the last little imperfections. But yeah, I mean, it's not perfect, but I think it's way better than it was, and it should be fine by the time I resurface it with the new vinyl. Oops. Okay, guys. Yeah, okay, so here's what we came up with in the end. All finally rewrapped. I don't know, I'm really happy. I reckon it's looking killer. Like glass, baby.
And I play Rachel Teller in Need for Speed Underground 2. Playing a racer in the game was a lot of fun, but on the streets, I make sure to drive safely and responsibly. When it comes to racing, make sure you only do it on the streets of Underground 2. So remember to always use your seatbelts and...
storm.
Bear with me, guys, I'm only playing one-handed. Rather hard to steer. But how cool is that? Gaming on the national Quintrix, or Quintrix, I think, TC-232037, the national Quintrix. Quintrix TC2037. Sorry, a bit hard to game and recall model numbers. Damn it, wiped out. Let's see though, I'm still winning. I can't believe it. Final lap. Oh no! Oh, I was coming first. Let's see if I can bring it back up. As I said, guys, I'm playing one-handed here.
Thank you. Truck for a spin.
Well, bring her along. This concerns her too.
Wait a minute, Doc. What are you talking about? And what happens?
Starting our approach, deactivate the security shield.
Security deflective shield will be deactivated when we have confirmation of your code transmission. Stand by.
You are cleared to proceed. We're starting our approach.
Hi, I'm Josie Merritt, and I play Mia in Need for Speed. Supervisor, suspect was last seen northbound past the Boundary Mall. Supervisor requesting you set up a corner ASAP. Units remain on code 6 status till further.